On this part of the NewsHour debate tonight, I have Manish Tiwari, Union Minister for Information and Broadcasting, who's debating with Chandan Mitra of the BJP. And also joining us, Swapan Dasgupta, Senior Journalist, and Vinod Mehta, Editorial Chairman of The Outlook. Kumar Ketkar with me in the studio. Harsimrat Kaur Badal stays with us for some time, and we'll divide this debate this way. We are going to cover three areas, ladies and gentlemen, in the course of the next 45 minutes of this live debate. First, we will settle the debate on 1984, because Harsimrat Kaur Badal says she has many questions. In fact, she said at 5 minutes to nine today, Manish Tiwari, she said, "Where is Manish Tiwari?" And we said to her, "Mr. Tiwari will come at 9 o'clock. So she has one question for you on that. Then we will discuss Gujarat and Mr. Rahul Gandhi's assertion that 2002 cannot and should not be compared to what happened in 1984, because 2002 Gujarat government was complicit and 1984 Congress Rajiv Gandhi government was trying to stop the riots. And then we'll talk about why he's not taking on Modi directly, why he doesn't agree to a debate. So I open the house in this part of the debate by asking Harsimrat Kaur Badal, you wanted to make a point to Manish Tiwari on 1984, go ahead. Manish Tiwari, she had a point to make to you. Then I will intervene after your response.
My first question to him is, does he stand by the statement of Rahul Gandhi saying that the Congress government in 1984 massacre worked to stop the massacre?
Okay,
does he stand by this statement of his? Number two, if he says that Modi was the CM in Gujarat, hence he is responsible, Rahul Gandhi's father was the PM, and hence he should also be responsible, or does that hold no responsibility?
Point taken. Now, Manish Tiwari.
I would like to know.
Okay, point is taken. Miss Badal.
I would like to know.
Miss Badal, if you take too many points together, we won't get an effective enough response. Okay. The idea is to start the debate, but I'm afraid you might take it over. Manish Tiwari, would you like to respond? And then I will take it over. Yes, Mr. Tiwari.
Well, I think Mr. Goswami, as my colleague Dr. Abhishek Singh, we articulated, what happened in 1984 was absolutely reprehensible. It was horrendous. And that is why the Indian National Congress tendered an institutional regret followed by an institutional apology at the level of the Prime Minister. So therefore, you know, for Harsimrat Kaur Badal or anybody else, you know, to continue make that charge that the Congress party was allegedly complicit. The fact is that commissions of inquiry, allow me to complete, Harsimrat, commissions of inquiry went over that entire unfortunate chain of incidents which had taken place. Subsequently, there were charge sheets which were filed. Matters are in court.
No,
you know,
but
if the court
but
is taking
question,
its time. It is unfortunate. It should be
I question the logic.
But for anybody to level this charge against the Congress party that in any manner we tried to condone or we tried to absolve anybody who was allegedly involved
you're shifting the goalposts, Mr. Minister.
It's totally and absolutely wrong. It is completely
Mr. Minister,
absurd and it is totally out of
Mr.
order.
Mr. Tiwari, 1 second.
Six of them have named Sajjan Kumar and three of them have named Jagdish Saikler out of the 10 friendly commissions set up by the Congress party. Six named Sajjan Kumar, three named Jagdish Saikler. How come till today, 30 years down the line, CBI is trying to close the cases and the court is saying the cases cannot be closed? So if they are not abetting and shielding,
may I ask,
what are they doing?
Mrs. Harsimrat Kaur Badal,
Ms. Badal, Ms. Badal, Ms. Badal, please.
Right? May I ask her,
Ms. Badal,
one second. Hang on, may I just ask her, from 1998 to 2004, there was an NDA government at the center.
Why should we go to 98?
Her husband was a minister in that government. They had the CBI under their charge. They had all the instrumentalities of government at their disposal. Why weren't prosecutions expedited? Why weren't prosecutions fast-tracked? Why were those people not convicted? You know, Mrs. Harsimrat Kaur Badal finds it only convenient to make the 30-year charge. I would like to ask her, what was she doing? What was the Akali Dal doing? What was her husband doing? Who was a part of
of that government. Why did the CBI not act? Why did the courts not act? Why did the commissions of inquiry not act? And may I again, repeat, you know, for the sake of your viewers, that you have a party which is leveling the charge against the Congress, which went and attended the whole...
Gentlemen, sir, one second. We need to move to many other subjects.
Who is responsible?
We need to move.
Therefore, this charge does not lie.
Miss Badal, now please. Miss Badal, please hold yourself for a minute. Hold yourself for a minute and let me hold the debate.
You know, no civilized society can tolerate
now,
it.
Now, Mr. Tiwari,
this charge after having been in government
Mr. Tiwari, it is
populism and it is politics
Mr. Tiwari, populism. Populism and politics. Miss Badal, one second. Hold yourself, Miss Badal. In this part of the debate, and I'll let you come in, because I know Manish Tiwari has attacked you directly. And he has said, and don't respond. He has said, your husband was a minister in the NDA government. Why didn't you move the processes? Then you have a right to respond, because he's taken you on directly. But, Mr. Tiwari, as I also invite Chandan Mitra and the other panelists into the debate, the clear and effective counter to you, Mr. Tiwari, because you say Manmohan Singh apologized for the riots in 2005. Yes, he did. But doesn't the admission by Rahul Gandhi, nobody else, Rahul Gandhi, he admits probable involvement of congressmen in the 1984 riots. He says so in the interview. It makes the need for an apology now all the more compelling.
Mr. Goswami,
it makes it compelling,
Goswami,
he admits.
Now allow me to come back.
I thought you let Chandan Mitra in.
The fact is that Mr. Gandhi stated something which is the obvious. You know, after all, cases were filed against certain Congress leaders. Those cases are still going on in courts. So therefore, if you know complaints were filed,
I don't understand
those
this logic.
Translated into charge sheets, those charge sheets are being adjudicated in courts. Then for Mr. Rahul Gandhi to say that no congressmen were allegedly involved, you would have turned around and said that Mr. Rahul Gandhi is lying. Here is somebody who
he has admitted the guilt.
That yes, complaints were made.
Chandan
they
Mitra.
Are being legally adjudicated.
No.
So therefore, allow the legal process.
But Mr. Tiwari, Chandan Mitra is rebutting you now.
Correct.
Chandan Mitra to Manish Tiwari.
Mr. I am surprised that my friend Manish is arguing so vociferously, and I know what kind of tragedy he suffered personally as a result of militancy in Punjab. But the really sad part is that he's overlooking that while blaming the NDA, NDA was in power for 6 years out of the 30 that have transpired since the riots. They have been in power, the Congress, its allies, Congress-supported governments have been in power for 24 years. And yet, all those accused of leading the mobs with cans of petrol and kerosene, throwing burning tires through the necks of Sikh community members, raising their shops and houses to the ground, they are roaming scot-free. They were reinstated as ministers when the party came back to power in 2004.
Oh, yes.
And look at the legal process in Gujarat. In Gujarat, ministers have been, who were ministers at the time of the riots, have been sentenced to life imprisonment. The legal process has really moved fast track. So, and right from day one, the army was called out, riots were controlled, and the police, as you know, my colleagues pointed out in the earlier part of the program, police took stringent action against the rioters. I don't want to break up my community, but it's obvious that those who were indulging in kind of vandalizing shops of a particular community and so on, they were fired upon, they were killed, cases were launched. So there's no comparison. And how Mr. Rahul Gandhi could make this
after
absurd claim that in 84 that his government moved
why,
far.
Why did he not apologize? Simple. You know,
complicit.
No, Manish Tiwari. Manish Tiwari, I find this strange. No, no. No, no, one sec.
Now
I want to get Swapan Das Gupta and Vinod Mehta. One sec. Manish Tiwari, I'll come to you.
Extremely sanctimonious argument.
Arnab,
allow me to rebut the extremely sanctimonious argument which has been made by my very esteemed colleague, Mr. Chandan Mitra, for whom I have great respect. Let us rewind back to 2002. You know, if the police had really been active, how did the riots continue or the pogrom continue for 4 months? Why did the former Prime Minister, Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, have to remind the Chief Minister of Gujarat that he has to follow Raj Dharma? Why is it that the Supreme Court had to wholesale transfer all the riot cases out of Gujarat to Maharashtra and then the wheels of justice started moving? Why is it that when the convictions took place, it was
fine,
only when prosecutions were transferred out?
And
why is it that the Supreme Court was compelled to hold
has been
that while the heroes of Gujarat were fiddling, the state was burning? All this is also a fact. You know, in
they
one
can
particular
say whatever,
incident,
they can
if
say
the
whatever,
SIT has come
but
to
the
a
fact
certain
is
conclusion,
that each and every case has been
that the entire program in Gujarat took place,
case,
unfortunately, on the watch of their chief minister, who is their prime ministerial candidate now. I think the Bharatiya Janata Party, by trying to make this very sanctimonious argument, only ties itself up in knots.
I'm sorry to say, Mr. Tiwari is a lawyer by training, and he knows that cases that were thrown out of Gujarat or the cases that stayed inside, the Supreme Court directed investigations through the SIT, nothing, not one thing, has indicted Mr. Narendra Modi. So he has no business kind of, you know, pointing out to things that are history, and the courts have rejected them.
Swapan Das Gupta,
I have no respect for the court.
Swapan Das Gupta,
like
why are you convinced?
I'm saying nowadays.
Okay, one second. One second. You have to get the others into the debate. Manish Tiwari and Chandan Mitra, one thing. Swapan Das Gupta and Vinod Mehta and Kumar Ketkar, one second, please. Manish Tiwari, my question is to.
The state was burning.
My question.
Which are the heroes that the Supreme Court was referring to?
My question at this stage.
And how?
My question.
And who was the hero in my
My question at this stage.
Emperor of Rome.
My question.
The Supreme Court makes that stricture.
Gentlemen,
if the Chief Minister of
Gentlemen.
Would have had a modicum of responsibility, he would have resigned. He would have resigned there and then after the stricture of the Supreme Court.
I ask
there could have been a stronger
my
question than that. You know, for the
Why
court
now both gentlemen please. Both gentlemen please. Gentlemen, calm down please.
It's not even an incident.
Gentlemen, both of you please.
Of the Honorable Supreme Court
with
was direct.
I asked Swapan Das Gupta. Swapan Da.
Chief Minister of Gujarat.
I asked Swapan Das Gupta, Vinod Mehta. You know what happens? Two politicians in full flow. And one of them, also a journalist, another a lawyer. Which means the three other journalists who are neither politicians nor lawyers are going to be left out. And I'm not even counting myself. What a tragedy, gentlemen.
Goswami,
let's not make it happen.
Get left out of anything.
My question to Swapan Das Gupta is this. Swapan Das Gupta, take a position on this. Do you think the moral conviction of the BJP's argument in questioning Rahul Gandhi's lack of an apology on 1984 rings hollow, given the fact that Narendra Modi himself only expressed his pain? He only expressed his pain on December 27th when the courts gave him a clean chit in the Gulbarg massacre case. He didn't apologize. So who is Chandan Mitra to ask for an apology? Swapan Das Gupta.
Listen, Arnab, we are discussing not the riots per se. We are discussing Rahul Gandhi's interview. Let's be very clear. Rahul Gandhi came into that interview expecting something else. Got trapped by you into making certain indiscreet comments about Punjab, about Gujarat, for which he was clearly not prepared for. And that, in a sense, has become the central point of an election. Rahul Gandhi was completely unaware of the whole background of the 84 riots. He was ill-prepared for what he had to do, how he had to direct his attacks against Narendra Modi. And the basis of some ill-informed comments have become the substance of political discourse, which seems to be suggesting a certain paucity of it. But anyway, the point
is... Are you saying, Swapan Das Gupta? Swapan Das Gupta, 1 minute, I cannot resist. I cannot resist. Are you saying, Swapan Das Gupta? And if you say so, substantiate it. And I'm actually quite surprised that the Honorable Union Minister for Information and Broadcasting lets you pass unchallenged when you actually say that all the comments that Rahul Gandhi made on 84 and Gujarat and Narendra Modi and RTI and everything else were comments made out of ignorance. You actually suggest Well, that he Mr. made those Goswami, comments about 84 and Gujarat out of ignorance.
No, if I would have
I actually said it.
If I you said it.
I think a lot of what he said, shows a massive degree of underpreparedness to face the political
Mr. Minister.
And I think at every point, he was prepared for a debate on RTI. He was prepared for a debate on systems. He was prepared for a debate on women's empowerment. And you asked him questions on something else. He said it's not in the course and made a series of blunders. That's precisely what happened. And I think it reflects the paucity of, you know, ideas in this thing.
Swapan
this has become the main issue of
Swapan Dasgupta suggests Manish Tiwari must be allowed it.
May I just come in for a moment?
No, you know what he
may
says.
I just come in for a moment.
Yeah.
I think what Swapan, you know, is completely and deliberately ignoring was that in that interview, Mr. Rahul Gandhi was actually trying to set a new normal of Indian politics.
New?
By speaking a new language. A language of empowerment, a language of inclusion, a language of turning India into a manufacturing hub, a language of the future. Unfortunately, all of us who are caught in a very pedestrian narrative on a daily basis, you know, cannot recognize that new normal. So therefore, if you asked him certain questions, I think he responded to them, you know, extremely genuinely, drew the right analogies, you know, gave all the right responses. But what was striking in that interview and the takeaway from the interview was the new normal in the discourse that he was trying to
set. Mr. Tiwari.
Transparency, inclusion, making India into a manufacturing
hub. Mr. Tiwari, I can appreciate.
Mr. Tiwari, I can appreciate the fact.
May I just finish? You've made your point, Manish. I think the point is it's very noble of you to say that Rahul Gandhi was trying for a new normal, a new language, a new form of discourse. Unfortunately, when the old form of discourse presented itself, he found himself unable to comprehend its logic, while the new form of discourse seemed alien to voters who unfortunately are caught up in a very pedestrian logic, as you put it. Since these happen to be elections,
well, Swapan,
rather than the viva of
voters
a deep
or not,
I think it should be more
decide.
That,
well,
that the point is that the voters,
you know,
well, you yourself said that voters, the people are caught up in the pedestrian language. You said so yourself. Manish, you said so yourself. Manish, you
well,
said
what
so
I said was that,
that
he was prepared to look
Now, gentlemen, you both say, one second, this is now, the debate has gone in a different direction. We have been accused by the none
well,
other
that
than...
That is the direction in which it
was Rahul Gandhi
to.
Speaking
Mr. Tiwari, Mr. Tiwari, Mr. Tiwari, may I say so? Mr. Tiwari, can I just ask you something?
Mr. Tiwari? Whose worldview, whose politics begins and ends with the Gujarat Chief Minister. That is not the
okay,
Mr. Rahul
so Mr. Tiwari,
worldview. In
Mr.
your
Tiwari,
interview, it came out very clearly.
Mr. Tiwari,
and I think
you,
those are some of the things which really need to be debated in this country.
Mr. Tiwari,
don't
you
don't know anything about Mr. Rahul Gandhi's worldview.
Mr. Tiwari, one
what
minute.
What are his views on Pakistan? What are his views on national defense? What are his
well,
views on
well,
external affairs?
First of
none
all, let me ask you,
there.
Mr. Chandan Mishra, what are the views of Mr. Narendra Modi on decriminalizing gay sex? Let me ask you, what are the views of Mr. Narendra Modi on decriminalizing gay sex?
What
you know, today we have had a situation where the Supreme Court has dismissed the review petition. I want to know what is the Bharatiya Janata Party's position. I want to know what is Mr. Narendra Modi's position. What is Mr. Narendra Modi's position on decriminalizing gay sex?
Why don't we
have can I get a chance?
One second. Changing the system. I have a question for the Union Minister for Information and Broadcasting. Mr. Tiwari, you answer my question now. answer my question, and I have a question to you about the system. Mr. Tiwari, listen to me. Listen to me, Mr. Tiwari. Mr. Tiwari. Mr. Tiwari, 1 minute. Let me bring some order into this discussion. I request you, please. Vinod Mehta, I will come to you, sir. And Kumar Ketkar, I will come to you. But I find this astounding, with respect to you, Mr. Tiwari, that you throw an accusation today that all of us are lesser beings, wanting to discuss lesser subjects. We probably have lesser IQ, and hence, no, 1 minute, 1 minute, our feet are closer to the ground.
Please do not be condescending about yourself.
No, Mr. Tiwari, the last thing you should accuse me of,
Mr. Tiwari, the last thing, Mr. Tiwari, one second. If there is somebody who's trying to talk a new language of development,
Mr. Tiwari, I want to discuss things. If you hear me, please, Mr. Tiwari. Hear me, Mr. Tiwari. Hear me for a minute. Don't heckle me. I request you. And if you saw the 80-minute interview, Mr. Tiwari, you would know more than anyone else that I am quite a practiced villain in the art of bringing the discussion back to specifics. Now, let me say to you, Mr. Tiwari, changing the system is excellent.
Well,
I like it. I say this to you, Mr. Tiwari.
You're a practiced villain. You're a good journalist.
Fine, Mr. Tiwari. I was just being condescending to myself, which you told me a while back I should not be. Now, Mr. Tiwari, I want to change the system too, right? We all want to change. You want to change the system. I want to change the system. We all want a better system.
Now,
I have something very specific to Mr. Tiwari.
Now, so therefore,
Mr. Tiwari, listen to me. I have something very interesting has happened.
You want a better system, then what?
Something very interesting has happened recently, I want to tell you. A person called Sanjay Singh has got a Rajya Sabha nomination from Assam. He was rumored to be getting close to the BJP. Also, perhaps, I don't know why Swapan Das Gupta is amused. Also, perhaps crossing over as a possible candidate against Rahul Gandhi in Amethi. The Congress party flies him down. And lo and behold, a person the state of Assam, 1 minute, let me complete. A person the state of Assam knew as little as it knew Manmohan Singh when they made him the Rajya Sabha candidate, is sent there and ensconced as Rajya Sabha candidate so that he does not take on Rahul Gandhi in Amethi, who is anyway facing a tough time opposite Kumar Vishwas. Now, Mr. Tiwari, I will only take 10 seconds. I have to ask my question, Mr. Tiwari.
Please, and let me respond.
I want to ask. I'm not even asking you, Mr. Tiwari, whether systems can be changed by making a Rajya Sabha member.
Are you making an observation?
No, I'm making a question. I am not on superficialities. I am asking you tonight.
Mr. Tiwari, let's change the system.
You and me together will change the system if you answer my question. Just give me 15 seconds. Mr. Tiwari, 15 seconds. Give me 15 seconds. Mr. Tiwari, 15 seconds is all I ask for, not too much. From a man of your immense generosity, Mr. Tiwari. You let me ask the question. Otherwise, people will think.
Mr. Kuldeep Nayyar took it to court.
Mr. Tiwari, my question, Mr. Minister, don't censor me. As a union minister for information and broadcasting, you can't censor me. Mr. Tiwari, let me ask my question, sir. I want to change the system.
But you have a problem with
No, Mr. Tiwari, I do want to change the system. I want 10 seconds.
Why don't you ask the BJP?
I want, Mr. Tiwari, 10 seconds from you. You are stopping me. Mr. Tiwari, 10 seconds. 10 seconds. 10 seconds, Mr. Tiwari. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. 10 seconds, Mr. Tiwari.
Mr. Manmohan Singh, and he knows that.
10 seconds, Mr. Tiwari. 10 seconds. Give me 10 seconds. Chandan Mitra, 10 seconds. Can you change the system?
It was amended by your government.
My question is,
who subverted the constitution?
Mr.
Tiwari, Mr.
Kuldeep Nayyar, who was a nominated member of parliament, then took it to the Supreme Court.
Prime Minister,
it was upheld by a five-judge bench.
Prime Minister Manmohan Singh supported the system.
Mr. Chandan Mitra, I'm sorry, I don't want to get personal. You are a very close friend of mine. But are you a domicile of Odisha?
No, I'm not being personal. I'm asking you about your Prime Minister.
Are you a domicile of Odisha?
I'm asking you about your Prime Minister. Who subverted the system by filing as ordinary
resident in the Why don't you first answer about yourself, then I'll answer about our Prime Minister.
And getting forged receipts as a tenant of Hiteshwar Saikia, the then Chief Minister.
In the sense, you represent the state of Odisha in the Raj Sabha. Are you a domicile of Odisha?
No, Madhya Pradesh.
Is Mr. Balbir Let me correct you, Madhya Pradesh. The state that he represents? Is Mr. Jaitley a domicile
But the law was changed after.
So therefore, you will find
the law was changed after Dr. Manmohan Singh.
Vinod Mehta.
After Dr. Manmohan
Vinod
Singh flagrantly violated it.
Vinod Mehta. Gentlemen.
Manmohan Singh flagrantly
Gentlemen, all I said was. Now, Chandan Mitra, 1 minute and Manish Tiwari. Manish Tiwari, Chandan Mitra, two members haven't spoken. Vinod Mehta, can you. Vinod Mehta. Manish Tiwari says tonight.
The law allows.
I keep putting up my finger like this.
Law did not allow.
Manish Tiwari says putting up my finger like this, but nobody pays any attention to me.
One second, we are paying attention.
Why do you have a problem?
Manish Tiwari.
You cannot have double standards.
Manish Tiwari.
There cannot be duplicity and hypocrisy.
Manish Tiwari. Okay, Chandan Mitra, 1 minute. Chandan Mitra, don't respond. Manish Tiwari, 1 minute. Chandan Mitra, Manish Tiwari, 1 minute, please. Gentlemen, please, cease fire tonight. Cease fire or Vinod Mehta will walk out of the show. Cease fire or Vinod Mehta is about to walk out of the show.
Why don't you allow me to
okay,
put this
now
question.
1 minute. Gentlemen, one. Chandan Mitra,
allow
one.
Allow me to put this question.
Yes,
I haven't. Chandan has at least, I haven't had a chance to make a first sentence.
I'm trying to raise for the last 10 minutes.
Please, Chandan Mitra.
Nobody's allowing.
Chandan Mitra, let Vinod Mehta.
I keep putting up my finger like this. Nobody pays any attention to me.
Go ahead. Manish Tiwari accuses you of not understanding complex thoughts of the kind that Rahul Gandhi is putting forward. Vinod Mehta, respond directly to him. Don't pull your punches tonight.
Yeah. I mean, we are lesser beings. We are lesser beings. As you have said,
please keep these guys quiet. Please keep quiet. 1 minute, be fair.
Continue.
I mean, this is ridiculous. Arnab, I haven't heard such loft. I haven't heard. Arey, yaar, kab kya bole?
Go on.
Allow me one question.
I haven't heard.
After which you take over, Vinod.
Vinod Mehta will speak, please. Vinod Mehta is speaking.
Arnab, I haven't heard such lofty humbug for a very, very long time. It seems both the BJP and Congress is full of sins. They do nothing wrong. Now, on this matter of 1984 and 2002, in both cases, the state behaved abominably. The state was complicit in the massacre. We have all talked about 1984, but in 2002, Mr. Narendra Modi ordered a bund in Gujarat on the night of the incident, and the dead bodies were paraded right across Ahmedabad. What are we talking about?
Chandan, please. Mr. Narendra Modi was Chief Minister. Chief Minister cannot call a bund. Please get your facts right.
You are going to get into hair splitting. Let me just say that both in Gujarat
Narendra Modi called a bund.
Delhi.
How can a Chief Minister call a bund? He was not
Oh God. Chandan, this is very unfair. I mean, if you don't give me a chance to speak, then when I speak, I'll get my facts right, Chandan. You just listen.
Your facts.
What I am saying is,
okay.
The facts are that who called the bund? Who called the bond in Gujarat?
State BJP, not Narendra Modi.
The Vishwa Hindu
not Parishad. Narendra Modi, he was Chief Minister.
So what is state BJP? What's the difference? What's the difference between
no BJP today?
But what is the difference between state BJP and the Chief
there is
Minister?
No difference between party and government.
Huh?
There is no difference between party and government. There is no difference between party and government.
Of course there's no difference. Who ordered the dead bodies to be paraded through
Ahmedabad? That's a new theory. That's a new theory.
That's a new theory, Vinod.
But anyway, so what I am, I will
and he
comment.
Did it.
You can say all
and
this. And Chandan, please.
No, that's it's a fact that whoever ordered them, they couldn't have been done without official sanction. So I am saying that both 1984 and 2002, the state behaved abominably.
But that's not what Rahul Gandhi said. Vinod Mehta, that's not what Rahul Gandhi said. Rahul Gandhi gave Rahul Gandhi. No, Vinod Mehta, now I must intervene, please, despite your loud protestations. One second. Rahul Gandhi didn't say that. I am saying that. Sir, I am saying that
Rahul Gandhi was economical with the truth when he was talking about Delhi.
Swapan Das Gupta telling
the full truth.
Swapan Das Gupta, Vinod Mehta in a charitable manner says Rahul Gandhi economical with the truth when he gives the Congress government a clean chit. I don't know which side you mean he's being economical with the truth with Swapan Das Gupta.
He was telling lies.
Swapan Das Gupta telling lies.
No, I mean the point is he was economical with. He was very, very, he rationed his sense of reality quite a lot in this whole discourse with you. Because ultimately, as I said before, he came prepared for a discourse on certain things.
Yeah.
And when other reality, or what the real nitty-gritty of Indian politics, the humdrum of Indian politics, the hustle-bustle intruded onto the scene, he said a lot of things which are astonishing. Partly because he just didn't have a clue. Because he's so tied up in the new language that what he wanted, what has happened in the past 20, 25 years has only been seen by him through the vision of someone who happened to be living in the Prime Minister's household or has been living in a particular bungalow in Lachin's Delhi. So that sense of aloofness from reality was what was the hallmark of his entire intervention. And he has to remember that really when we expect someone to be Prime Minister, we expect a certain awareness of the realities of India, not merely a few keywords and certain template answers to everything. It was a keywords interview. That was what it was.
What
he said about 84, what he said about 2002, have no basis in reality.
Well, it's extremely amusing that Swapan Das Gupta makes that argument. You know, with all due respects, you know, some people who have been delusional about 2002, since 2002, you know, possibly find everybody else, you know, to be delusional about the reality. So I think, you know, before educating others about the brass tacks and about grassroots and about contemporary reality, I think first of all you need to disabuse yourself about your own delusions
as to what
happened in Gujarat, which unfortunately you've continued to defend, you know, very, very vigorously and at times, in a very brave manner.
Manish, we are discussing Rahul Gandhi, not me.
So therefore,
we are discussing Rahul Gandhi. I am not a prime ministerial candidate.
Of being delusional, you know.
I am not a prime ministerial candidate.
Of the reality. I think, first of all, you need to do a reality check yourself, my dear friend.
No, what he's saying, Manish Tiwari and Kumar Ketkar, is Rahul Gandhi's approach too theoretical, too bookish? You know, when I ask him, for example, that who else will Congress MPs choose if not Rahul Gandhi, he probably might say, yes, they can. But then he says, no, democracy is not about non-arbitrary decisions, it's about arbitrary decisions. Is there a certain theoretical element to his discussion? What Swapan Das Gupta is saying?
You've raised an important question.
Let me complete my point.
There is a person who's trying to put in processes. to see that
Kumar Ketkar,
parties, especially the Congress
party, one second. Kumar Ketkar, you buy that? Manish Tiwari, I'm sorry, but Mr. Tiwari, when I'm asking him, how can you give, this my question goes to Kumar Ketkar, senior journalist, when I'm asking him, how do you hold Modi responsible when the SIT testimony has been upheld by the courts, and he says that we have to move towards democratic processes, different philosophies, push democracy, youngsters, empowering youth. And I ask him that question again, then he talks about empowerment, democracy, women's empowerment when I'm asking him about Narendra Modi. That question is either that is a deliberate attempt. Now, either Kumar Ketkar, well, there are two the possibilities, reason, a deliberate well, attempt to avoid the question.
Well, for the simple reason.
Either a deliberate attempt to avoid the question, or...
Let me answer it off the bat before you...
No, let Kumar, let me get a third perspective on it, then you counter him.
I started off by saying that certain people's, entire...
Or maybe it was incomprehension.
It begins and ends with the Chief Minister of Gujarat. In the case of Mr. Rahul Gandhi, it is not that.
No.
So when, you wanted to focus the entire discussion on a particular point, but he answered you straight. And he told you what he felt about it. And since you referred to the SIT and the exoneration, after all, it was the exoneration
I still don't understand, Mr. Tiwari. Mr. Tiwari, maybe I'm... Mr. Tiwari, please indulge me by listening to me for a minute. If I were to ask Kumar Ketkar a question about Gujarat and SIT findings, would you respond by telling me about right to information?
What was the
tack in your view there? Because Manish Tiwari explains by saying that he's talking at a higher level while rest of the people are talking at a lower level, and he's trying to raise the political debate to a higher level. Everyone is at a lower level. But my question, at even if it was at a lower level about Modi, could have been answered at that level instead of trying to elevate it to the level of right to information, Kumar Ketkar.
Actually speaking, for the last 40 minutes, I am not actually clear as to whether the debate is about between 1984 riots and 2002 riots, about the delusions, about Rahul Gandhi's role. Rahul Gandhi said he was 12 years old at that time and he doesn't remember everything.
So 13-year-old,
talking about 13, whatever, and I don't remember everything. Are we asking or accusing Rahul Gandhi? Are we discussing Rahul Gandhi's interview? Or are we discussing 1984 and 2002 riots? 1984 and 2002 riots cannot be compared. I think anybody can notice state had withered away in Delhi and state had withered away in Gujarat. You cannot compare any two riots. Both are hugely human tragedies.
That's not his argument. No, that's not his argument.
I'm not talking of Rahul
Gandhi.
That's
not his argument.
I'm not talking of Rahul Gandhi.
No, that's not his. But I'm talking about Rahul Gandhi's argument.
Meaning the panelists, have sometimes discussed comparison between 1984 and 2002 and sometimes talked about 2002 interview about Rahul Gandhi.
I asked him about the question about 1984 and 2002. He said don't compare the two.
Yeah, exactly.
Because my father's government did everything to stop it.
The question was comparison. Two riots can be compared.
That's a wrong argument.
Kumar Ketkar cannot be compared with
Mr. Ketkar, you are giving another theoretical argument with respect to you.
You are comparing two riots, Mr. or you are discussing only Rahul Gandhi's interview. 1984 cannot be compared with 2002. 1947 cannot be compared with 1992.
Kumar Ketkar,
when Kalyan Singh was the UP BJP chief minister.
Kumar Ketkar, your argument today is as facetious as saying you can't compare this flower to that flower. You can't compare this fingerprint to that fingerprint.
Of course, you are comparing two situations which are fundamentally different.
I get Swapan Das Gupta and Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra raised his hand. I think that's a facetious argument.
It is not facetious argument.
I think it's a superficial argument.
Because the panel is not clear as to what we are discussing, Rahul Gandhi's interview or two riots.
But you
ended up discussing two riots.
Rahul Gandhi drew a distinction.
Your initial debate between Mr. Fazal and others was
was about riots.
Sir Rahul, sir, you vociferously come out in defense of Rahul Gandhi. I appreciate the fact that you've done so. But at least please kindly consider.
I have not defended Rahul Gandhi. Kindly, I have not offended kindly, Rahul Gandhi. Kindly, I do not want to take it.
I have great.
I'm just asking you to make it clear.
I have great personal regard for you. You are a journalist of great eminence. You are 3 decades my senior. But yet I will ask you this, Kumar Ketkar, very clearly. Rahul Gandhi said, and I didn't say. Rahul Gandhi said, Chandan Mitra, he said, don't compare it because Congress government did everything to stop it. And no. Gujarat government did everything to push it. Now that's his logic, not mine, Kumar Ketkar. I'm not making some argument like you can't compare two riots. No. Don't accuse me of.
That is a complete correct statement by Rajiv Gandhi. Don't, I will defend Rajiv Gandhi's statement because I have covered 1984 riots as well as 2002 riots okay, as well as 1992 riots. So and I can completely
agree with
Rahul Gandhi's statement that 1984 riots and 2002 riots are different.
Really?
In 2002 riots, there was abetment and direct participation.
And there were, and what was the Nanavati? What was the Nanavati Commission about? Did the Nanavati Commission not say, Kumar Ketkar, about the involvement of congressmen at a lower level? But was the Nanavati Commission
Rahul
fiction?
Rahul Gandhi himself admitted that.
Was the Nanavati
but
Commission
Rahul
fiction?
Rahul himself admitted that some Vinod Mehta. Were responsible.
Vinod Mehta, please. Vinod Mehta.
Arnab.
Yeah.
Arnab, what a fantastic interview you have done. And why? And we are just spending our time talking about 1984 and 2002 when we should be looking at what kind of impression did Rahul Gandhi convey. What kind of leader is he? What are his thoughts? Will he be able to transform the Congress? This is the main thrust of your interview.
What's your take?
Why aren't we talking about that rather than 1984?
What's your take?
We are never going to get any consensus between 1984. My take is that he, for all his faults, Arnab, he took some very tough questions from you for 75 minutes. He did not walk out like some other chief ministers. And we have some notion of what kind of vision he has. It may be fuzzy, it may be
Swapan
full of generalities.
Swapan Das Gupta, two hands going up, limited time. Swapan Das Gupta responding.
I tend to agree with Vinod Mehta, but can Mr. Vinod Mehta enlighten me on one point? What did Rahul Gandhi mean when he said that Lalu Prasad Yadav is an idea? What did he mean by that?
Lalu Prasad Yadav.
The question was on corruption, and he said Lalu Prasad Yadav is an idea. Is an idea.
Yes.
But you tell me.
Could you elaborate? Maybe because my limited sense of normal language failed to,
let Manish Tiwari answer that. No.
What he was saying is that
Manish Tiwari will answer that.
Manish Tiwari will answer that.
What did he mean by saying Lalu Prasad is an idea? Mr. Tiwari, go ahead.
The Congress is not getting into an alliance, if at all it gets into an alliance, with an individual. Political parties have alliances with other political parties. Political parties do not enter into alliances with individuals.
Chandan Mitra.
If Mr. Swapan Das Gupta cannot understand that reality after being a political analyst for over 4 decades now, then I'm sorry, I do not...
I can't understand the idea.
Chandan Mitra, last word.
Deliberately. He knows very well that Mr. Lalu Prasad is no idea. He is the antithesis of an idea. And that his party is a party, family-run party. When he is not chief minister, his wife is chief minister, and now his son is being groomed to be the leader. There is no such thing as an idea in Mr. Lalu Prasad's party, the same dynastic policies are followed there as they are
Chandan,
followed
what
in the
is
Congress
the idea
party.
Of welcoming and back Yeddurappa into the
Chandan,
BJP?
May I ask you,
Chandan,
Chandan,
what is the idea of
about
welcoming
Himachal
back?
What about Mr. Dhumal and his son? What about Rajasthan, your chief minister and his son? And I can go on chapter and verse. So therefore, before you accuse others of dynasty, look at what is happening in your own party.
You know, I'd say...
Dynastic thing is a different
gentlemen,
one.
Gentlemen,
please answer, what about Himachal Pradesh? Father chief minister, son member of parliament. Rajasthan, mother chief minister, son member of parliament.
Manish Tiwari. Manish Tiwari, 1 minute. Mr. Tiwari, on a lighter note, I have one thing to ask you.
Lalu Prasad is not an idea. Lalu Prasad Yadav and his family.
No, one second.
Totally, if you have an alliance...
No, but
with
I'm
the RJD,
why
you have an alliance with Lalu Prasad Yadav. There is no RJD
with
Lalu Prasad Yadav.
What about
so
the Chief Minister of Rajasthan and the
idea?
Mr. Lalu Prasad, I can only say. I can only say, gentlemen, 1 second. If Lalu Prasad is an idea, is a very weighty idea, and Manish Tiwari kindly
is the fodder scam animal husbandry.
Yes. Yeah. And yes, exactly. And you, Mr. Manish Tiwari, we seek your forgiveness tonight. All of us, we seek that you, Mr. Manish Tiwari, absolve us
In the case of
kindly.
Lalu Prasad Yadav, pragmatism.
No. I'm asking Manish Tiwari. I'm asking Manish Tiwari.
Ask my question.
I'm asking.
Before Manish answers, let me put my question in relative silence.
I don't think you have any right to subject Manish to any more grueling.
No, I'm asking Manish Tiwari this. Manish
Tiwari. Manish Tiwari,
absolve.
I get the drift.
No, your leader has taken it. Your leader has done it. Arnob was being accused of child molestation yesterday on Twitter.
I would only also humbly like to request you in a lighter way. Please don't subject
Arnob, did you realize you were being accused of child molestation yesterday on Twitter?
Hello,
gentlemen, I'll say one thing. Manish Tiwari, please absolve us, lesser beings of lesser thoughts and lesser questions. May we evolve.
Mr. Arnab Goswami, I absolved you a long time ago of being judge, jury and prosecutor at the blood fest we have every night on prime time.
Well, Mr. Tiwari, that was on a lighter note. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me on debate number one.
Seeking your permission. My question remains unanswered.
Okay, thank you for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight. The BJP question remains unanswered. Thank you.